The Godot engine can produce some amazing games, and here are 10 of them, in no particular order, because they all are equally awesome.
Are you a good viewer? Yes, you are! And this is your well-deserved treat. Protocorgi is an adorable Barkem-up that was developed by the indie studio Kimono Games. Corgis are a simple and effective way to make everything better, and it works for shoot-em-ups too. Look at that! It's so cute, he barks, they die! It's amazing! But if you look under the layer of cuteness, oh, there's another layer of cuteness! But below that are really solid shoot-em-up mechanics. You have weapon upgrades, 27 weapons, most importantly lasers, and screen clearing attacks. They also have really big bosses and difficulty levels ranging from pop to ultra nightmare. The game's release is planned for this winter, but you can play the demo right now. I don't know, there just should be more corgi adaptations of genres. Make corgis Creed, please. I like corgi assassins. And then Corgi of Duty, the legend of corgi.
They say you should not have a favorite child, but Kingdoms of the Dump is my favorite child. It just looks like an amazing Super Nintendo RPG, which is the best kind of RPG, if you ask me. It's a bit like Chrono Trigger and Earthbound made sweet sweet laugh while Lufia watched them. The sprites just perfectly capture that SNES aesthetic, with bold colors and Mode 7 style effects. I trust this game to deliver a great story. Look at this one for example. Walker Jacket. He is a gunman slash librarian, a member of the Order of Book's End, and arguably the most feared librarian in all of the Lands of Phil. He spent years chasing down overdue books and lost library cards, but now must lend his service to a greater cause. And by the way, the game was created by two real-life janitors.
Fist of the Forgotten is all about the fisting. You can punch enemies to make them less alive, but you can also punch the air for a kind of directional dash. And you can break walls. Damn, this fist is like a Thermomix. It can basically do anything. Unfortunately not sponsored by Thermomix. You move really fast, but you can look really far ahead so you don't run into things all the time. The movement just looks super fluid, with additional mechanics like sliding and a grappling hook. This is supported by a clear art style and very fluid animations. It could turn out to be a really nice game for speedrunning. The developer Jitsbo has a pretty cool beard and a YouTube channel and made some other stuff as well, so go check that out.
Cruelty Squad just looks so disgusting that it... No, it simply looks disgusting. I never came across a game that is such an eyesore. But still, there are people who love this game, despite that. And that must have a reason. First of all, the ugliness is very well made. The colors are precisely chosen to annoy you as much as possible. And your grappling hook is actually your intestines. The FPS shooter gameplay is fast-paced, has a good variety of weapons and flows pretty well. But fitting to the visuals, the gameplay is punishing. This game just embraces its rough edges wherever it can. Levels that make no sense at first sight. Armor that clutters your screen. It is not a beautiful game, but the world has a place for unpleasant music, for disgusting paintings, and it has a place for Cruelty Squad. Give it a try to enjoy the pain, I guess. Oh, by the way, if you liked the video so far, give it a like so that more people get confronted with the amazing beauty that is Cruelty Squad.
So you like highly replayable tactical RPGs with anthropomorphic animal characters? Okay, oddly specific. But good for you! The Black Pepper Crew has a great aesthetic and overall vibe to it. You can collect your squad and gear them up with tons of items. Then you kick mean bandits' booties and collect the bounties. The game really needs a lot of thinking to optimize your party for maximum cuteness while remaining somewhat effective. Of course, you insta-pick the wolf and the frog, but how do you go on? And I am pretty sure that is Octodad, so there's that. Definitely check out the demo as well as Queechy Pixel's devlog on YouTube.
Sometimes I feel like playing Star Fox on the Super Nintendo, but without playing Star Fox on the Super Nintendo. And this is why it is a good thing that Ben Heichling made X-Zodiac. It captures that vibe really well, but runs a bit better than the games in the 90s did. It has 12 levels with secret side routes and bosses. No wonder this game got funded 250% on Kickstarter. The only thing left to wonder is, will you be able to do a barrel roll?
Longtail builds around a really simple core mechanic really well. You are a white square that likes to collect golden squares, but you can only move in straight lines. Whenever you move, you leave a wall behind you that you can use to bounce off of. It is just really chill and well polished. Listen to the undo sound with me. It is just too satisfying. I sometimes listen to it for hours until the neighbors complain. After a while, the mechanics get pretty wild with spikes, mirrors, and portals. Just be careful with the German localization of your title, Mr. Kamil Rams.
Dark Crypt is a turn-based stealth puzzler that plays in a crypt, which is dark. If you like dodging the line of sight of spooky creatures, this game got you covered. You can leave marks on the ground and teleport to them later. My brain usually is not made for puzzles, but everything is clearly drawn out, and the best of all, it has infinite undos. That is great, I am good at making mistakes. The game was made by Daisy Games and is planned to release in October this year. You can play a demo right now.
TaleQuest Defense is a mix between tower defense and puzzle platformer. It sounds like a wild combination. The most important thing, you can shoot a centipede that is made out of cake with a cannon. And this is what games are for. There are also tomato mines. Everything is just so cute and colorful, I love it. Also, obvious bonus points for the animal protagonist, because animals are amazing in general. It has couch co-op. This is great. I have a couch. TaleQuest is being developed by Kiwano Games, and it is featured at the October 2021 Steam Next Fest. So, if you are still here, you might like games made with Godot engine. Good thing we are also making a game with Godot. It is called First of Us Fungeon, and it is a fast-paced wizard roguelike. Here is a large fireball, and this is our dash mechanic. You can chain it to kill everybody. Go wishlist on Steam. A demo is coming up this year.
Tempest Bound is a beautiful platformer with physics and puzzles. I really like how the game uses the restricted color palette. It works really well with the physics, water reflections, and lighting for some reason. The protagonist seems to be half man, half owl, and half fox, which is cool. And it seems like we are to expect a pretty dark story to explain how that happened. This game by Jason Sum also features a speedrunning mode, so you can compete against your friends in case you have any. If you want to see more Godot games coming up, push this. We also played games made by our community recently. You can see that up here.